Here, you guys voted for these people to sit in these chairs. You guys put their names on their ballots or whatever, but you guys need to hold them accountable for whatever they do. You guys need to go to events, to function, to make your friends present. You can't pick and choose. You guys can't pile on people when you get called out. You can't get your feelings hurt when people call you out on it. That's not what it's for. That's why you guys are there. That's why you guys are elected to be there. You guys are government body. You guys are government employees. We're private citizens. We have every right to redress our government however we want. Long as there's no violence, long as there's no nothing threatening, but we have every right to express how we feel. Religion, everybody has their own religion. You know, I'm Catholic, you know, I don't pray like all you guys pray or whatever the case might be, but religion is protected under the First Amendment. You know, there is between church and state, you know, there is that, but you guys do whatever you want. Anyways, this whole thing, having this police chief live here in the city of Escondido and using the money of the $250,000. My time's not done yet.
Yes, it is.
Efraín Hernández.
Good evening. I'm Efraín Hernández, living at 1209 North Paseo de Ogate. I appreciate the opportunity to come before you today and I acknowledge those of you of the community today. As some of you know, my family were transplanted here by the Creator of heaven and earth only a few years ago. Since coming here with my wife and children, we have devoted our days to helping and supporting this community through our grassroots nonprofit ministry to our works and mysteries, an acronym that means trust, obedience, respect, and honor in the Creator. The word Torah itself is a name of what most people call the law of God and represents the first five books of the Bible. Human dignity is derived from these essential tenets of Scripture, commandments, statutes, and judgments of the Lord. Through the process of getting to know this community, the mayor, and this council, I have come to understand a belief in God, the creator of the Bible, the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. This being true, I encourage you as a brother, a fellow human, to stand up for the right, for what is right and true, to do unto others as you would have done unto you. In every decision that you make as a body, consider the poverty-stricken taxpayer and voters of Española that are doing everything they can to scrape by. I was made aware recently that a report was to be created for the closure of the Santa Clara apartments. The city manager was responsible for creating this report, and that Councilor Manny Martinez had made about it in a previous meeting. Mr. Jordan, where is that report?
We don't engage with public comment.
I'm just making my point. As was stated a few moments ago by Mr. Stephen, I personally have had a lot of voice opposition to the solicitation ordinance, and I still feel that ordinance needs to be stricken from the city law.
The night is far spent.
I'm just about finished. The day is at hand. Let us therefore cast off the works of darkness, and let us put on the armor of light. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
That would be it.
Thank you for all that signed in for public comment this evening. Moving on, we don't have business with visitors this evening. Councilor comments. Councilor Benavides.
Thank you, Mayor. I wanted to just start very quickly with sending kudos out to our code enforcement department who worked really hard. Recently, they were on duty and they came across a senior citizen in really bad shape. They contacted the city manager. He had them contact me. I went to the house and probably one of the worst situations I've seen. Today, working together, we have an apartment for him. We'll be moving him in tomorrow. I also want to
Your time's up.
We'll let everybody know at that time a little bit more about audio. I don't have an update on audio. So I just want to send kudos out to everybody. I know Bob has been working early morning and late nights, as has City Manager working from home. I also want to give a big thank you to the directors that did fulfill their budget requirements and get those to City Manager so we can move forward. In addition to that, I just want to give a quick update on the Silvery project out there. I met with Samantha Price and I yesterday, and we discussed pricing for the homes. The architect has done a great job. Jordan might have a little more to update than I do during his comments, but we hope to bring something to council soon so everybody can see the beauty of that project. We're working together with RTD for their portion of the project. It hopefully will be a beautiful facility. We're trying to set the prices where they're affordable to individuals and the rents as well. So in addition to that, Mayor, a little bit of an update on the VSLW apartments. We're moving forward and doing everything we possibly can to keep individuals in their house. And I think City Manager may have a little bit more to update on that as well. Thank you.
Any other comments or comments?
Thank you, Mayor. Thank you, Council Denise. Concerning code enforcement, you know, accountability always runs uphill in city business. So I was grateful that code enforcement was out and was able to identify that senior, but without having the support of somebody here in the office, explicitly a city manager that allows them to research how we can forward that situation and help them. And along with yourself, just doing what you do from your position at Santa Fe County and working with Rio Viva to make sure that somebody in this community that's so badly in power land up in an apartment like that. So thank you for your efforts, Councilor, and thank you, Jordan, for supporting that. You know, if a code enforcement officer brings something like that to the higher ups, and the higher ups says, well, too bad, then it's dead in the water, and that's the end of it. So I'm grateful that we have somebody in the office here at City Hall that has a heart for our people and that wants to make a difference and do what they can do for those that are most needy in our community. Big shout out to three departments, four departments actually, streets, gosh man, what can I say, you guys are everywhere. Recently, I've had a lot of calls from different people telling me how grateful they are that you're cutting weeds here or cutting weeds there or fixing that pothole or fixing things throughout the community. So we're so grateful for everything they're doing. The parks are starting to look a little bit better. We want a lot more improvement there. I'm sure that we're going to have to throw some money at that for sure in this next budget round. Fire department, I'd like to shout out, they had a structure fire on Fairview Lane where there was a possibility of a second person being in a burning structure. I was there and I witnessed the fire department literally going in turn after turn, taking turns to see if there was another body in there and pull out another person, risking their own life. So thank you guys for the work that you do. The police department recently had drove us here in the valley. They had two right before that. They're working on some more. So we're so grateful for that. We deal with staffing issues all the time in the PD. It seems like a revolving door. It's sort of scary, but we just have to keep forging ahead. So thank you, Chief, for the work that you do in our community. We're so grateful to have you. Concerning the North Central Solid Waste Authority, the board meeting scheduled for tomorrow morning has been canceled because Chairman Alex Naranjo will be out of town. It has been rescheduled for the 20th. So again, North Central Solid Waste Authority meeting will be had on the 20th. I recently did receive a letter from Chairman Naranjo asking that the City of Escanilla does not get a vote because we are in a disagreement over the amount owed to them for the time where North Central did not get the city trash and the city picked their own trash. So we're hopeful that that can get worked on without it getting very sticky. In the meantime, we look forward to that meeting and seeing what happens with that. We're looking forward to the fiestas of the City of Espanola, the celebration that should happen with that. And also looking forward to celebrating this community's anniversary, centennial anniversary coming up. So we need to plan a I appreciate the time that you give to this community, and I'm so grateful for you all. Thank you.
Councilor Rodriguez.
I'll just make it really brief. Thank you for your comments, councilors. Thank you, city manager, for your hard work. And I want to thank the community for coming in and joining us in our meetings. We look forward to having more of you coming. It's really important that our community works together. So please come back, and thank you for coming again.
Any other councilor comments? Going on Zoom.
Thank you, Mayor. Just a really quick follow-up. I know at Public Safety, I did get Chief and ask that you thank your staff. I just wanted to mention how quiet it is at the Vista del Rio, thanks to the Chief, the property manager, and just others that have been involved in helping to clean up that complete area. People are out walking again, walking their pets, and we're hearing a lot of good things from there. So I just wanted to make sure and thank you, Chief, and your staff as well.
Any other councilor comments? Councilor Salazar? I'm going to move on to matters from the mayor. I'd like to thank all the staff that's been working so hard, and I'd like to express to the public to give us patience with getting a lot of the potholes and such that are needing to be patched. We've had some utility cuts. Now in June, we have to be able to go out and go at a certain time and go and fix for the hot fix. One of the things that the city of Escondido doesn't have, and I asked the manager to get quotes and bring those before the council, is to bring the hot mix truck, which would be able to fix and patch minimal situations, and we probably utilize from the enterprise fund. He's going to compile some quotes. But the public needs to understand that during the winter, we can't obviously put asphalt because it's too cold, and then we have to time it right with the hot mix plant and the transit mix where we can get the load and do multiple spots all at once. So it's all strategic, and I really want to appreciate our field operations department that worked so hard on doing that. But please, and especially now with the rainfall, I get it, you know, the ruts are really exposed, so we just have to have patience out there. And most importantly, I want to thank all of you that came this evening to express your comments and your concern for the future of discussing our faith here in the council chambers. I think it's really important to our community. Our community is united by our culture, heritage, and ultimately our faith. That defines who we are as a valley. It's been in our traditions for years. You know, it's so important that we're united by something. And so coming together tonight shows the unity of who this valley is and what defines us. Mm-hmm. So we're grateful for you to come this evening. I'm hopeful that you'll come for future meetings about very important issues. Because this is your valley. This is the beautiful Espanola Valley. And it's so important when you have the initiative and demonstrate that by coming this evening. So thank you all, and thank you for showcasing and showing your pride and ultimately your response that people believe that there's a silent minority when it comes down to our faith, but you came tonight and you discussed why we should continue to have faith in our house of chambers.
That's not what we should be about. We shouldn't be fighting about faith or anything like that.
Mr.
You know, that's
Obama, you're out of order. You're out of order, Mr. Obama. You're out of order. You're out of order, Mr. Obama. Other than that, I would like to bring forward tonight appointment of Lodgers Tax Board members. And I have presented to you, I indicated early on we had an issue with the appointment of Lodgers Tax Board members on a simple basis. That we haven't been able to fill the board. It's been a board of five, and we need two hotelers to serve on this board. Unfortunately, nowadays, the hotelers are no longer local operators, and they're all chains. Discussion with the attorney, we issued the opinion that we can appoint a board that can conduct business based around the two members that are members of the hospitality tourism industry and one at-large member. And that's what I'm submitting this evening. I'm hopeful that we can get two hotelers within the near future, but it seems to be very difficult. You know, when you have chain operators running hotels, the managers aren't as invested and they don't care. And obviously what happens locally at Days Inn in Espino, New Mexico doesn't really affect the pocketbook of the corporate San Diego days. So I'm recommending tonight for approval. I'm recommending the appointment of Mr. J. Patrick Trujillo, owner of the Chimayo Trading Post, Mr. Pablo Izar, owner of Ken's Cuisine, and Mr. Pedro Valdez, community member, and the two owners of the Chimayo Trading Post and the Ken's Cuisine, serve as the tourism hospitality industry, and Mr. Peter Valdez represents the community at large. Mayor Pro Tem Peggy Sue Martinez.
Second.
Second by Councilor Denise Benavides. Under discussion.
Under discussion, Mayor. So the protocol for receiving tax, water tax board funding will be the same for everybody applies, correct?
We don't have a policy in place. So I'm hopeful that the board can meet, convene, and create a policy. So Mr. Yancey, correct me if I'm wrong, there's roughly $2.6 million in annual waters?
That's an issue to count. Not all is water tax. There's quite a bit of other things in there. It's been sitting and building all these years. The city really never utilized it.
So it's around $2 million?
No.
The policy that you're alluding to that's to be created will come before this goes to
of course. I'm hopeful that they can meet as a city board, draft some policies, and then bring it to the
tower.
Pretty much are being modeled, I think, after the county, where they have it open, they have it two times a year, and they solicit applications and proposals. If they meet all the criteria and such, the board makes a recommendation for the amounts, and then brings it before the governing body to approve for the disbursement.
Thank you, Mayor. I think that's a great idea. I really appreciate you getting on top of it.
And I want the governing body to understand a lot of tax isn't just limited to giving to public nonprofit entities. Lodger's tax can be utilized, for instance, for gateway signage, for marketing initiatives, all those different things and aspects. At one time, the Lodger's Tax Board was actually called the Escondido Marketing Tourism Committee for a long time, and that's what they utilized the money for. If you remember all the Christmas decorations that used to be up here out on Yaque for many years, those are all paid for by Lodger's Tax back in the days. You know, the actual, when you come into town with the poles, with the wire poles, that was paid by Lodger's Tax. So, I mean, these are examples of ways how we promote the city, utilizing Lodger's Tax, but Lodger's Tax isn't just limited to giving it to events that host in the city.
Awesome.
And it can also be for special projects, too, as well. Capital projects.
Or art projects.